So what's so special about Gulp? I teased it a little already, but let's have a closer look. The main difference between Grunt and Gulp is that Grunt focuses on configuration, while Gulp focuses on code. But what does that even mean in practice? Have a look at this Grunt configuration file. It's not important that you understand everything it does right away. We'll get to that later. It uses a JavaScript config object to configure certain tasks, such as concat and uglify. To change or extend one of these tasks, you would have to modify the plugins themselves. Consider the same functionality in this Gulp config file instead. It looks much more like standard JavaScript, and that's a good thing. At any given point, you can intervene and pipe your files into another function before moving on. The second big argument is all about speed. Grunt executes tasks in sequence, one after each other, while Gulp, by default, executes tasks in parallel and finishes when all have finished. But that's not all that makes Gulp usually come out much faster. Gulp comes with a concept of streams that cause much less I/O or file system access, and James will tell you a bit more about how streams work in just a bit. Head to the Gulp installation instructions in the instructor notes and install Gulp on your system. If you haven't done so already, you need to install Node.js and npm before that, and those instructions are also in the note. If you need a little more help figuring it out, the next note will have more detailed instructions.